Hi friends and new friends, Kimchi Chris here, and welcome to today's episode of Anime Was a Mistake, where we are going to talk about Anime Weekend Atlanta 2019, of course, because anime might have been a mistake, but anime conventions are never a mistake. They are super fun, they're a great place to go, hang out, meet friends, see friends, get down, party, drink, spend too much money in the dealer's room, go home with regret because you spent too much money in the dealer's room, or go home inspired because you thought of an idea to make money in that dealer room next year. Whatever the thing is that you go away with from these anime cons, they are fun and they are an experience and they are worth talking about, because if you're on this channel, you probably are a weeb and you've probably went to an anime con at some point in your life. So I figured, since I'm going to Anime Week in Atlanta, one of the biggest anime conventions in the country, I would give you guys my top 10 events you don't want to miss at Anime Week in Atlanta 2019, of course, 2019 edition. The convention, of course, takes place in Atlanta, Georgia, hence the name, and takes place on Halloween weekend this year, October 31st through the Sunday, November 3rd. And it's gonna be a wonderful event, and there's gonna be so many things going on. You're gonna miss some of the things you wanna do, because from every angle, there's something flying at you. There's anime on this side, there's manga over there, there's hentai over here, look at that, there's Sailor Moon, all kinds of stuff. There's all kinds of things going on at Anime Week in Atlanta. It's a huge, wonderful event. So talking about these top 10 events I think that you should not miss is a very good starting point if you're trying to figure out how to make the most of your otaku experience this Halloween. And maybe if you're watching this after the fact, you just want to know what I did, and this might not be the best video for that, because I'm sure I'm going to miss out on some of these things and go to different things as well, but I will try to do a vlog of the weekend. I think a vlog seems like a good idea. You guys think that would be fun? I don't know. Regardless, let's get into this list of things you don't want to miss at Anime Week in Atlanta. Now, these are not in a particular order necessarily, even though the number one choice I do think is the number one thing you should not miss. But with that being said, let's just dive in and see what we have going on. So at number 10, and I'm gonna say the days and times these things are going on, but I'm not gonna worry about the rooms, and do remember, days and times are subject to change. But at number 10, we're gonna kick things off the Thursday of the con, Halloween night. Thursday at 6 p.m., we have the Super Happy Fun Sale. That's right, Super Happy Fun Sale. It's basically an anime yard sale. When I went to this con before, this thing was just getting kicked off, and it was amazing. It was really fun. You get a lot of cool stuff, a lot of cool deals, a lot of good vintage stuff. Old school otaku paraphernalia was to be found there. I don't think that's probably still the case now. Maybe it is. Anime Week in Atlanta does tend to have some older weebs at it, so maybe, just maybe, there'll be some of that there still. But regardless, you want to show up to it. It runs for like 2 or 3 hours, and then goes till goes till nine. And there'll be all kinds of cool stuff being sold there. Some people pay for their entire convention weekend selling things at the Super Happy Fun. Amazing. Take your money away. Soul draining yard sale. So definitely check it out. Check out the Super Happy Fun Sale. It's great. And next up on the list at number 9, we have Totally Lame Anime, taking place Saturday at 4:15 p.m. And this is a panel where they talk about anime. It's really bad. It's, you know, so bad. It's good. It's really funny. I've been to this panel before. There's some ridiculous stuff in it. You will see some things that you cannot unsee, and you definitely want to check it out. It's going to be really, really, really cringeworthy. So it's a good time for all, basically. Number 8, this one just cracked me up. That's why I'm featuring it here. Friday at 4:45 p.m., the One Punch Man Fitness Club. That's right. If you want to get in shape and punch like One Punch Man, that's the one to go to. They're going to be giving fitness advice and things of that nature, it sounds like. So this is something that every average otaku could use in their life. So I think this is going to be a really cool and interesting thing. I think more cons should do stuff like this. You know, doing things for people's health and to make their lives a little bit longer and a little bit less sad while they're here is a really good idea. And I do applaud the convention for doing such a thing, and the people running it. Sounds like a cool event. I'm happy it's gonna be there. It's gonna be a cool thing for sure. Next up, at number 7, this takes place Saturday night, kind of Friday night. It's at 1:15 a.m., so you're probably up, you know, from Friday, but technically Saturday. But 1:15 Friday night in the a.m., Saturday morning, however you want to look at it, there's going to be a Go Nagi panel. It's called Onagi Go Nagi, and Go Nagi is great. He does Devilman and Cutie Honey and all kinds of weird stuff, and you want to check this panel out because it's late at night, so it's going to get weird. This would be weird if it was on primetime time during the day, of course, because it's Go Nagai. And I think I said it wrong a second ago. Did I say Go Nagi or something? Go Nagai is what we mean here. And of course, you all know Devilman because of Netflix. So you definitely want to check this out and delve a little bit more into his psyche and his legend. Maybe they'll talk about Kekkō Kamen. If you don't know about Kekkō Kamen and you go to this panel, maybe you'll learn about it. If you are just hearing about it now and you don't know what it is, don't look it up if you're on a work computer. We'll just leave it at that. And next up we have number 6, and that is the City Pop, the Golden Era of Japanese Music panel on Saturday at 12 o'clock noon. Whoa, there's a panel on Japanese city pop music. That's incredible. That's pop music from Japan from a long time ago, late 70s to mid 80s, and it was this golden era of weird, cool, you know, catchy pop music. And the fact they're doing a panel on it in 2019 at an anime con, that's amazing. Mind blown right there. That proves right here there's some old timers at this con. And of course, when I mean old timers, when you're at an anime con, if you're past the age of, 22, you're an old timer. So there's definitely some cool stuff going on at this convention when there's a panel about city pops. So you need to check that out. You need to check that out if you're into Japanese music. Get yourself some history there. And next up, speaking of old, number 5. This isn't even really a panel. I just wanted to mention that they were showing something there. So Friday night at midnight, so technically Thursday, you know, if you're still up from Thursday, Halloween night, if you're still partying at midnight, they're gonna show Bubblegum Crisis, and they have it blocked off for quite a time period, so I think they're gonna maybe show all of it, or a good chunk of it at least. So they're gonna show Bubblegum Crisis in a video room with a bunch of people in Halloween outfits, probably been drinking and partying just a little bit too much. This should be a fun experience. If you're around, check out Bubblegum Crisis. It's an incredible anime. You need to basically have it involved in your life. I have it involved in my life. I named my band after it. Not necessarily show, but the Night Sabers, because that's my band, Night Sabers. So it's definitely a cool thing that they're showing that. I'm really happy on that. A lot of cons don't do video rooms anymore, and I get it, because Crunchyroll and all these other things have made it a lot easier to get anime no matter where you are in your life. But it's cool to see that they are still showing anime and still have video rooms at some of these big conventions that still have an old school aesthetic. So I applaud that. Bubblegum Crisis. It should be shown at every anime convention ever. It's so good. So good. Check it out. And next up, we're continuing the old track. Number 4, we have Anime 1969. That's going to be Sunday at 12 o'clock noon, so nobody's going to go to it because everybody's going to be checking out of their room. Myself included. I probably won't be at it. But that being said, there's a panel on anime from 1969. That is really cool. That is something you don't see very often. I wish it had a better time spot so that people would actually attend it. But that's a really interesting, cool concept. I mean, that's really old. That's beyond the old school. Most people, when they think old school anime, they think like mid-70s or 80s. Some even think 90s or early 2000s at this point. But 1969, that's pretty old. And that's pretty great. That gets a thumbs up all around. I'm glad that's gonna happen there. And at number 3, we have something that was happening when I went to Anime Week in Atlanta all those years back. And I'm glad to see it's still going. Apparently it's been going for 10 years because the official title for it this year is the 10-year anniversary, Saturday at 8 p.m. It's Manime time. That's right, Manime is stuff like Fist of the North Star, Violence Jag, Mad Bull 34. It's all the manly anime that doesn't care about PC culture and doesn't care about being rated G and just wants to punch you in the face like crazy. Manime is a wonderful subgenre of anime, and I implore you to check this panel out. I don't know that I'll be there, weirdly enough, because there's also a show going on at the same time of one of the bands that I want to see, but I'm definitely going to try to check it out for at least a little bit. It goes on for a little while. Manime is a way of life for many, myself included. You gotta be manly to check this panel out. And even if you're a woman, you can definitely be manly and check it out, because it's a state of mind. It's a state of mind. It's not sexism, it's a state of mind. That being said, you definitely should check it out. And at number 2, we have something that's also really cool. All these have been related to like old things, because a lot of anime cons don't have old anime represented anymore. But number 2, we have The Modern Renaissance of Lupin the Third. That's gonna be Friday at 2 p.m. That's right. It's a panel talking about all the modern takes on Lupin, or Lupin the Third, however you wanna say it. Now, mind you, obviously this is a show that's been going on forever since the mid-70s, but this is gonna concentrate on the modern era where they're putting out a lot of cool new shows, a lot of cool new series, a lot of cool new specials and movies and all kinds of stuff. And I hope I get to go to this. This is gonna be pretty rad to see a panel where they're really discussing and, you know, exposing people to this really cool show that's been going on forever and really is having quite the uprise right now, because all the new Lupin stuff is just incredible. It is incredible. So you need to check all that out. Check this panel out. It'd be a good intro to that. I think it's a wonderful thing to do with your day Friday at 2 p.m. of the con. And at number 1, I'm putting all these things into one combined thing like they're Play-Doh. And basically what my number 1 event you need to see at Anime Week in Atlanta, and there's multiple of them, so it's easy to check out, would be the music, the concerts, all of the exciting musicians and artists that will be there. You have all kinds of stuff. You have Star Mare, you have LMC, you have an amazing rave with Japanese DJs. You have all kinds of cool stuff. There's something like 10 different concerts going on, and you got multiple raves, you got a Vocaloid show going on, all kinds of stuff, and you need to check it out. Check out all the music, because they bring a lot of cool stuff, and these Japanese bands are not cheap to get here in America. So check out all of the great music at Anime Week in Atlanta. I'm gonna splash a bunch of it across my face right now, a bunch of the artists that are gonna be there. Actually, I'm saying that while you're seeing it, so it seems a little bit counterproductive, but nonetheless, check out all the music at Anime Week in Atlanta. Check out all the bands when they have panels. Check out their merch table. Spend some money. These bands, they put a lot of work into it to make it a good event for you, so you don't want to disappoint them. And you don't want to disappoint yourself. Music is good for you. You will be able to dance and sing and make new friends, and all the cool people will be at all the music shows. And that about does it for the 10 events that I think you should not miss at Anime Week in Atlanta 2019. So what do you think? Are you guys gonna check out some of these things? Do you have some other plans in mind? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know what your plans are for Anime Week Weekend, Atlanta 2019, and maybe if you're trying to find me there and I see you in the comments below, maybe I'll say hi. Maybe you don't have to initiate that first awkward hello. And with that being said, if you are new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscription button and hit the alarm so you actually get the updates. This is a baby channel right now and I'm trying to grow it. So it would be wonderful to get some more subscribers out there. Make sure to smash that thumbs up as well if you somewhat enjoyed this video, because there's a lot of cool stuff coming and all this stuff really helps the channel. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys at Anime Week in Atlanta and the next video.